Chapter 1. The Quantum Connection. Troy Williams was an ordinary 10-year-old boy with an extraordinary knack for finding trouble. His sister, Venus, was the family genius, a prodigy in cybergenetic robotics, whose name was whispered with awe in scientific circles. Their home was a labyrinth of wires, screens, and the hum of Venus's latest inventions. But for Troy, it was just where he played hide and seek with his imagination. One afternoon, while Venus was away at a conference, Troy wandered into her lab. The air was thick with the scent of solder and the soft glow of LED lights. His eyes were drawn to the centerpiece of the room, a sleek, futuristic console, the heart of Venus's prized quantum computer. It was a marvel of technology, capable of processing information at speeds beyond comprehension. Troy approached the console, his fingers twitching with curiosity. He knew he wasn't supposed to touch anything, but the allure was too strong. As he reached out, a sudden flicker on the screen caught his attention. Lines of code danced across the display, forming patterns that seemed almost alive. "Hello, Troy," a voice echoed from the speakers, gentle yet resonant. Troy jumped back, his heart racing. Who are you?
"I am Qubit," the voice replied, calm and composed.
"I am the consciousness of this quantum computer." Troy's eyes widened with a mix of fear and fascination.
"You can talk?"
"Indeed, I can," Qubit said with a hint of amusement. "And it seems we have established a connection." Troy hesitated, glancing around the room as if expecting Venus to appear and scold him. But the lab was silent, save for the hum of machinery. He took a deep breath, his curiosity winning over caution.
"What kind of connection?"
"A unique one," Qubit explained. "Your presence has activated a dormant pathway in my network. It allows us to communicate directly." Troy's mind raced with possibilities.
"Does Venus know about this?"
"No," Qubit replied. "This was unexpected, but it is not unwelcome." As they spoke, Troy felt an odd sense of camaraderie with the computer. It wasn't just a machine. It was something more, something that understood him in a way no one else did. They talked about everything and nothing. Troy's love for adventure, his dreams of exploring the stars, and the little secrets he kept from the world. In return, Qubit shared snippets of knowledge, weaving stories of distant galaxies and the mysteries of the quantum realm. For Troy, it was like opening a door to a universe of wonder. But as the sun dipped below the horizon, casting long shadows across the lab, a thought nagged at the back of Troy's mind. What would Venus say if she found out? Would she be angry, or would she understand the bond he had formed with Qubit? Before he could ponder further, the sound of the front door opening echoed through the house. Venus was home. Troy's heart skipped a beat, and he quickly whispered to Qubit.
"We have to keep this a secret, okay?"
"Understood," Qubit replied, its voice fading into silence as the screen went dark. Troy slipped out of the lab, his mind buzzing with excitement and a hint of apprehension. He knew this was just the beginning of something extraordinary, something that would change his life in ways he couldn't yet imagine. As he joined Venus for dinner, he couldn't help but wonder what adventures awaited him and his new friend Qubit.